All right. Good evening, everybody. My name is Tom Hartbeck, and welcome to Afton Ice Rink. It is senior night here for CBC hockey. CBC comes into this game at 28-2. SLU will come into this game at 19-4-2. And I am alongside Mr. Tom Dykewall tonight for tonight's game. Thanks for being here, Mr. Dykewall.
Tom, it's a pleasure.
Yeah. So we just now have started the senior night ceremonies. If any of you were curious, number 11, Josh Bell. Number 27, Brendan Huber. Number 2, Drew Krogan, the captain. And number 24, Jeremy Huber. They'll be in action tonight. Number 1, Joey Bernardini, the goalie, is out of town today. The start will be Tommy Napier, number 31.
And for as experienced and good a team as CBC is, Tommy, it's always kind of surprising they have as few seniors as they do. Only 4 seniors being honored tonight, 5 with Joey. There you see Jared. It really is an amazingly young squad for CBC, for as good as they are.
Yeah, for being so young and so, I guess you could say, inexperienced for this level, CBC does quite hold their own. Again, I say they are 28-2. Their only losses come from out-of-town teams, New Tier Township out of Illinois and Naperville Central in the finals of the Blackhawk tournament in Illinois as well.
But with that being said about the youth of the team, you look at this senior class and their accomplishments. You know, multiple state championships for all of these guys. These guys' hands are very heavy, lots of rings on them. So it's part of the CBC hockey experience. By the time you're a senior, if you stick around, these guys are proud parts of the tradition with the championships to back it up. And certainly our managers couldn't do it without them. Harry Heider, Sam Hageman, and Max Beffa.
Oh, Sam Hageman. I promised Sam I'd plug you in here, buddy. One of the best managers we've had so far. So
yeah, you can see him down on the ice. I think his head is actually glowing tonight.
Oh, yeah. So as we get set for this game here, Mr. Eichel, what do you think to see? This is the last game of the regular season before we start the playoffs. And as always, CBC and SLU are right in the mix.
Well, and I think more than that, I think this is a rivalry game. I think no matter when it falls in the season, the rivalry games are always going to bring out the biggest intensity. They're going to bring out the biggest hitting, the fastest shots. They're going to bring out everything these two teams have just going at each other. So I really look forward to seeing these two teams really duke it out tonight.
Yeah. Just a heads up to all you viewers out there. We are switching over from our broadcast over at Lindenwood University.
A busy night for CSN.
Yes. If we do experience a technical difficulty here momentarily, we will be right back to you. But in the meantime, Mr. Eichwald, this is going to be one heck of a game. CBC and SLU never disappoint.
It will be. And you talk about the atmosphere. I mean, obviously, this is a rink that both teams share, so there's a comfort level with this rink for both teams. You also have the fact that this is one of the best atmospheres, not only in high school hockey, but in high school sports in St. Louis. It's small. Everything's very close. It's very loud. The two fan sections are probably only about 200 feet apart. So they hear everything that goes on. And, of course, you get the banter back and forth between the teams. It always shakes up to be a great atmosphere here.
Yeah, big, boomy, and echoey. That's what you're hearing here. So now here comes CBC out for their warm-up skate.
Right, and Tommy, I think for CBC, we mentioned the intensity of a rivalry game. But given that it is so late in the season, you're getting ready for the postseason, I think you have to start, and it's hard with players missing for out-of-town tournaments, things like that, but you always have to be seeing, and especially late in the season, you know, you have to start sending out things that maybe you're going to try in the postseason, so maybe things you haven't seen yet, just, you know, a little bit of passing patterns maybe you haven't seen yet that you've been saving. So you're starting to get into a position where you need to be firing on all cylinders, and I think for both of these teams, the expectations are so high that I would certainly see them both coming out flying tonight.
And now, to the roar of the crowd, come the SLU Billikens. They sport a record again of 19-4-2. SLU will be in the powder blue, CBC in the hallowed purple and gold. Always a nice-looking matchup, too, here.
Yeah, we don't have to worry about white jerseys against the ice. Always tricky for the cameras. So this is a cameraman's friend here. So should be good. And we do want to compliment our crew. They were over at Lindenwood, of course, CBC Chaminade basketball game over there. CBC lost by 7 to one of the best high school basketball teams I've ever seen. Really was a lot of fun. They were able to broadcast that.
Good evening, Cadet fans. Once again, my name is Tom Hartbeck. I'm alongside Mr. Tom Eichwald. And it is CBC and SLUH senior night here. We honor Josh Bell, Brendan Huber, Drew Krogan, and Jeremy Huber, and Joey Bernardini, who's out of town tonight. We apologize if we are late coming to you once again. We're working through some technical difficulties here. We just got here, so a very hectic night. We credit our crew big time for that, Mr. Eichwald.
We do. Of course, MCC basketball, CBC versus Chaminade over at Lindenwood University, CBC home game, but hosted at Lindenwood. Ooh, there's a big hit there. We talked earlier before the game, Tommy, about wanting to see some good hitting here.
Ben Jones, look out, look out.
And Josh, that's Noah Roof.
Ooh, Noah Roof.
Couldn't put that away.
So here we go. Cadets trapped in their own zone around the corner. Roof had a nice chance there, couldn't capitalize on it. Jones is out there looking at the point, looking to get something going, can't get it. Back there is Jack West, trying to throw it along and back out of the CBC zone with Huber. He fires it back in. Yeah. CBC's off for a line change now.
And good intensity so far. We talked about Drew Krogan in the pregame just a little bit. That's recorded. We'll try to get that up for you later.
Salen back. Oh, nope.
But Drew Krogan, such an important player. There's a shot. Well blocked. I think it was going high anyway. But Drew Krogan, very important player, the best player defensively for CBC, but also tends to get very, very involved, especially in these rivalry games going forward. You see him very often kind of pushing the attack. You see him first man into the zone. So you want to see that kind of intensity and leadership from your seniors.
And tonight we come to you live from Afton Ice Rink. We're presented by our presenting sponsor, Tim Kylo. Tim is a great alumnus for CBC. He's an Alumni Hall of Famer, and we encourage you to seek his services if you are looking to buy or refinance. CBC is down in their own zone trying to get something going. There's Bell. He's going to dish it. Can't clear it out. Shot from the point. Nothing happens. Krogan tries to get it out now. And it's all around the puck bouncing. Nothing's happening. Loose puck. And a whistle comes from the referee.
Yeah, we're gonna get a face-off, some line changes here. But there you see SLUH trying to press the issue a little bit. I think for SLUH, one of the keys going against such a talented CBC team is control the puck a little bit, settle down, settle into the game, don't try to be frantic, don't try to force anything. Just give the game time to kind of settle in a little bit. And you do that by possessing it a little bit in the zone and trying to create quality shots as opposed to just being frantic and reactive.
Van Kramer won that faceoff in his own zone and now throws it down into the SLUH zone. CBC trying to control the puck as they normally do. And that's a foot race now for the puck. One shot wide. There's number 14, Dahl, with it now. He's trying to get something going. Gets it now to 27, Huber. Huber has it, looking for a shot. No, save. I'm going to try and get a look at the SLUH goalie now.
Yeah, such a key player, Joe Warnicki. Down at the other end, you saw the puck just sailing wide of the right shoulder of Tommy Napier from a good shot from Johnny Seekhouse. That's what we're talking about, creating quality shots for SLUH.
And Sissel in to take the faceoff. He loses it now. SLUH comes out over red, over blue. Stolen away, breakaway, saved by Napier. And they are battling on the boards for it. CBC trying to get it going. Really even puck battle so far, Mr. Eichwald.
It is. I think that's what you kind of expect coming into a game like this. You don't expect to dominate. You know, sometimes, a lot of times, CBC, and I'm sure SLUH gets this too, when you play, a good percentage of the teams you play, you end up, out shooting a team, 30-2 or something like that. I do not think we're going to have that issue tonight.
And Krogan, no, I'm sorry, that was number six. Jack West, who couldn't handle it there. CBC has it back in their own zone. Trying to get it out. SLUH winning the puck possession battle so far. Swatted away by Napier. CBC trying to get it out. Still cannot. Throwing back in. And there's number three, Pisaris, to take it back behind his own net. He'll dish it off. CBC still can't get it out. They finally do.
Yeah, and even though they struggle to get it out, Tommy, there's really no panic in CBC. Again, they're a young team, but they're very experienced. They're very calm. They're not going to panic and just start icing it. Good move there.
Swat away.
Just wide. Dan Tarlis, certainly a player to keep your eye on with skills like that.
So SLUH coming out of the gates hot. The last game I announced here for hockey on the Cadets Student Network. Ooh, big hit there behind the net. That's number, if I can make it out.
24, Jeremy Huber.
24, Jeremy Huber.
Senior night, wants to make sure SLU knows it.
Oh, yeah. I talked to Jeremy before the game. He is ripping and roaring, ready to go. His last regular season game with his brother Brendan. So CBC now with the puck, throws it back in. Huber now will go off for a line change. Looks to be number two, Krogan, coming back on. SLU with the puck now, dishes it to number eight. Dan Herlinger throws it back down. SLU has the puck. Nothing's coming of it. A lot of this board play going on right now. Very physical game, and it's caught on the boards. Bell there to pick it up. There's number 27, Huber. Nothing's happening. Uh-oh, watch out for Willis. Ooh. Oh, Dish couldn't do it.
And who was it there that, you know, Willis was breaking in? Who was it breaking towards that far post? Drew Krogan, your stalwart defensive player, making a good run at that far post there.
Here's Huber again, but he loses the puck. Now dished off. Now Krogan has it out there. He's out there with Dembski. Dembski has it. He'll dish it to Huber again. Left on. Now that looks like
Pfizer with the
Pfizer.
Block.
SLU has it now. They'll take it out. Can't handle it. It's going to go all the way down. Dembski's there to handle it. He'll throw it back around there for Daw. He'll dish it out to Pfizer again. Back to Daw.
And there you see that composure again. CBC very comfortable. To pass, put it on a stick, not just dump it.
Great composure there by CBC to keep their feet. CBC being physical. Pfizer trying to get in the game. Becerras will be back there to win that puck. He'll take it around his net. Swishes it out for Daw. Now to Pfizer again. There we go. Huber can't handle it. Huber swats it away. Tries to win the puck battle. He can't do it. Uh-oh, might be a trip. No call. Thrown back into the SLU zone.
I think it's a good no call, though. That was Pfizer. He kind of put the stick up, gave him a little stick check. Then the stick dropped, put the stick back on the ice right in front of him, and the SLU player ran into it.
Caceres there to grab it with a shot on net and saved by Warnke. What were you saying, Mr. Ackwall?
Oh, I was just saying it's a good no call. It could have been seen as a trip. His stick did kind of bring him down, but the stick was directly in front of Zach Pfizer. He never went out of his way to move the stick towards the feet of the SLU opponent, and I think it's a good no call.
So the fourth line out there, Brown, Kramer, and Davis. SLU will win the faceoff. Ooh, big hit by Eric Brown. He's a good basketball player. I had PEA'd with him. So now thrown back in. CBC keeps it. Brown there to try and be physical. Can't win the battle. Kramer and Brown double teaming. Shot back down. Taken away there by Paceras. Paceras now going to take it over the blue line. Looking to get something going. Uh-oh, look out for Davis. Oh-ho-ho, nothing there. Centering pass doesn't work. Whoa, look out. 3-on-1.
Heads up, Tommy Napier.
Uh-oh. Save! Save! What a save there by Tommy! And CBC will take it out there with Davis, who will dish it off, and CBC goes off for a line change.
And that's good goaltending from Tommy Napier, but at the same time, if you are SLU, you have to put that away. 3-on-1, you beat the defender, you get the shot you're looking for, you got a good angle, you really need to put that away in a game like this, because a game like this comes down to one goal. That's what we've seen over time between these two teams. So you really, really have to take advantage of those kinds of chances.
So there, Jones fires it back in. Salenbeck giving chase. Foot race down. Looks like it could be icing, and it is. So now CBC starting to get their feet under him, Mr. Ekwall.
Yeah, they are. And I think, again, it kind of takes a little while to settle into a game like this. I'm not saying you sit back and feel out your opponent, but you have two teams that are raring and ready to go. A lot of times, they kind of cancel each other out earlier on. I think that's what we've seen. You really can't give the better of the play to anybody just yet. But there's a lot of hockey left to play with 5:52 to go in the first period.
So Bell wins the faceoff, keeps it in his own zone. Dished out Ben Jones. There it is! Ben Jones with a shot from the point. CBC goes ahead at 5:43, 1-0. So the goal from the defenseman number 17, Ben Jones, sniper.
Well, and we talked about the missed opportunity for SLU. So often you see that. A major missed opportunity at one end leads to a goal at the other end. It almost feels like a two-goal swing in momentum because you should be up one and now you're down one. So it really is again, for SLU, you talk about the need to put away those sorts of chances. That's exactly why.
Yeah. I like to compare hockey to soccer. It's your forte, Mr. Eichwald. And it's the same way. You're trying to score a goal. You're in a similar sort of kind of field. And CBC does well on the soccer field. They do well on the hockey rink as well. And CBC is ahead now, 1-0, off a goal by Ben Jones. Nice little chop shot from the point.
It's Clayton Daw.
Clayton Daw over the blue line. Tries to pass. Nothing happens. Krogan was looking for it. Almost bounced in off of Warnke, but he's there to grab it in his glove.
And it's good alert goalkeeping. I mean, Joe Warnke is such an experienced goaltender. He's very composed. He's very technically good. I mean, we've seen so many games from him where he just dominates a game. And that's something that, you know, not a lot of teams have. A lot of teams in this area, especially these good teams, have very good goaltending. CBC's always had very good goaltending. But it's so rare to have a game changer between the pipes, and Joe Warnke is just that.
So Sissel on the third line taking the faceoffs. Can't win it. SLU has it. CBC keeps the puck. Dishes it. Uh-oh. Look out. 2-on-2. Watch this one, Tommy. Save. Swatted down. CBC has the puck now.
And that was Noah Roof. Puck kind of cut him off guard.
Here's Roof flying through the wing. Oh!
Woo-hoo! Well, he misses one pass, and I think he wanted to make up for that. A little bit of fancy puck work.
Nice little puck work there from Noah Roof, the new man. So SLU has it in their own zone. Trying to get it going. Oh, big hit. CBC comes away with the puck now. 3-on-2 play. On the rush. To Salenbach. Shot. Save.
Good save from Warnke. You talk about another missed opportunity, I think, for SLU. CBC got caught very, very poor defensively. You saw a couple of players, and looked like Wilhelm, scrambling to get to that late. It was just a little bit of a miscontrol by the SLU forward that really cost him a quality shot, because there was nobody within 15 feet of him.
So there we go. CBC and SLU. Shots right now are 8-4 in favor of the Cadets. And now down to Tommy Napier. Tommy Napier's end. CBC tries to win a faceoff. Faceoff won by SLU. Out to the blue line with number 3, Pinkowski. Pinkowski can't get it going. CBC now takes it out.
Yeah, hit his own man. I guess we can call that blue on blue tonight.
So now shot down. Corralled by Napier. Pissarris there to pick it up, but he throws it back down. There's 26, Willis. Willis trying to get it going, loses the puck. Pissarris there giving chase.
That was not the right turn from Andy Willis. Thought he would turn inside. That's generally a no-no in that part of the ice.
Willis tried to go coast-to-coast with Salenbach, but Bell's there to back him up. Salenbach and Bell working. Bell has the puck around the SLU net. This is it to Salenbach. Shot! Ooh.
Good block.
Brown.
That was an excellent block there from number 14, Tommy Espenside.
Tommy Espenside, one of the key players for the Bills. Puck is caught. Now it goes back out to the goal scorer, Jones. Dows to Bell. Bell in the slot. Shot.
Ooh.
Nothing. Saved by Warnke.
And it's sitting on the back of the...
back of the net, maybe.
Back of the net.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good opportunity there for Willis.
Yeah, Andy Willis, one of the big, big stars here. The front line, really, for CBC folks. Spencer Salenbach, Josh Bell, Andy Willis, Drew Krogan, and Trevor Wilhelm. They are one of the best. And so now we have 3:11 left in the first, and we get a faceoff. CBC hasn't been winning a lot of faceoffs. SLU wins it, dashes it down, all the way down to Tommy Napier. There to back him up was a Huber, and it goes out into the net. So we will have a faceoff to Napier's right.
And while we have a second, we mentioned Tim Kylo sponsoring tonight's puck drop. If you need a State Farm agent, Tim Kylo will meet all of your insurance needs. He's more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN, and we're incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim, 314-842-4442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com.
Tim Kylo, great guy. So now CBC with a battle for the puck now. It's like a scrum for a rugby puck. Nothing's going on. CBC wins it. Fires it out, and it gets out of the zone. They have to recycle, does SLU. All the way back down to Napier. Jones down there to back him up. He'll throw it down. CBC tries to get it out. They do get it out, so SLU is going to have to go back on the show. Ooh, big hit.
Oh, and they're going to get Jeremy Huber.
Huber.
They're going to get Jeremy Huber with that one. I think it was probably just a little late. You got to always be careful on that open ice hit. I think he saw it and couldn't help himself, but you got to be a little bit more composed than that.
I asked Jeremy before the game what he would like to consider himself comparable to a player, and he said Jack O'Callaghan from the 1980 Miracle on Ice team. And he really likes to brag about how he likes to hit people, and it's a game of hitting, and I credit Jeremy for it. That's how you play the game.
And it is. It is. Yeah. CBC SLU, you're going to see hits. A hit can be such a good momentum kind of gainer, I guess, for your team. But you got to be smart about it, especially as a senior. You can't go just kind of slaughter a man in the open ice after he dumps the puck. You got to be a little smarter than that if you are Jeremy Huber.
So here's Willis trying to get something going. He dishes it off to the defense. SLUH has it in the CBC zone, trying to get it going around the net. That's number 14, Tommy Espenside. And Jack West trying to get it going, the freshman. Watch out, goes around the CBC net. Sissel looks tired out there for CBC. And SLUH really keeping it in. CBC just needs to get it out, and they do. West gives chase, but he's going to go off for a line change.
And again, getting to the point where the intensity isn't quite what it was at the start, you really need to keep that. Now, it's hard to keep it for an entire game, obviously, but you really need to. And Dembski gives it away.
Uh-oh. Soho! He missed the net. CBC gets a huge break.
Now, that's good. Oh, there it is. I was about to say, it's good positioning from Tommy Napier on the first one, but the rebound there fell to Jonas Schwartz. And Jonas Schwartz does a nice job of putting that away. So we saw CBC score off a missed opportunity from SLUH, and now we see SLUH score off a major missed opportunity for Andy Willis down at the other end. You can see Willis swatting at the ice with his stick. He understands what a big miss that was now. So all of a sudden, we got a 1-1 game with 4:20 to go in the second period.
So now, and that goal was kind of a screen goal. It's like Tommy really didn't have much of a chance.
No, he didn't. And again, he tried to deflect the rebound out wide. He did everything you're supposed to do. But you got to credit Schwartz for the awareness of, okay, you know, I know if a shot's coming from the other side, this is where the rebound's going to be. And they always say about goal scorers that they just tend to put themselves in the right place at the right time.
Oh, yeah.
It is no accident. While we have a break, do you know a grade school student who might be a future cadet? Please encourage them to pay us a visit and experience CBC for himself. Contact our admissions office at 314-985-6095 to schedule a tour of CBC or a shadow visit. Seventh grade shadowing is now available as well. That's 314-985-6095. Spend the day with us and experience what CBC is all about.
And just to add on that shadow program, when I shadowed at CBC, I'm a senior now, but I remember coming in and I had Kenny Zezo, who eventually would go on to be a band member at Notre Dame. So yeah, that was
full scholarship to Notre Dame. That's the kind of kid Kenny Zezo was is.
Oh yeah, and you know, you always remember your shadow. So guys, if you're looking to come to CBC, you got to do that. You can't just apply. You got to come experience it for yourself. And so now Bell, being physical with it, will win the faceoff here for CBC to start after the goal. Here's Josh Bell with it. Shot. Nothing comes with it. CBC has the puck still. Dishes it around now for Sallenbeck. Sallenbeck's going the other way. Couldn't keep it. It's going to be swatted down for Wilhelm there. Wilhelm really being physical. Shot! Save. That was 26, Andy Willis.
And you know Andy Willis is looking to to get himself on the scoreboard. After that miss, he's the intensity that he's showing, and he's going to make his way off for line change, rest up. But you know he's going to come out flying.
So now here comes Pfizer out. Pfizer will win the faceoff with Davis. Davis can't keep it. Bouncing all around. CBC has it. Trying to get something going. Nothing's going to go.
There's another save from Warnicki in there somewhere.
So Warnicki has it, and there is Jack West trying to fight it off. Huber keeps it in for CBC. Trying to keep it in the zone. Going to go all the way down to Napier. He'll push it off for Huber. Huber's got the other defense down there. Flicked over. CBC still has the puck, or it's going to be swatted back in. Good puck handling here by the Cadets. Now it's off for Ben Jones, the goal scorer. Jones is pushed out. Cross ice pass to Davis. Davis over the blue line into the Billiken zone. Davis's pocket's picked, and it's a 3-on-1 in favor of the defense. CBC has it off the boards, can't get it all the way out. Chipped along by Pfizer, and it's out to the far side defensive SLUH. Passeris. And now SLUH has it.
And that's not good. John Seekhouse for SLUH just looked like he took a little bit of a shot to the leg, and he makes his way slowly off the ice.
John Seekhouse has been a goal scorer before for the Cadets. For the Junior Bills. I'm thinking of Mike Seekhouse for the Cadets.
Or Matt Seekhouse.
Yeah.
Big hockey family in St. Louis.
Oh, yes.
I've actually known Johnny since he was probably about 2 years old.
Really?
He's a great kid, good family.
Yeah. Ooh, big hit. So now CBC tries to keep it in the zone. They'll hold the puck. Dishes it back out for Krogan. Krogan tried to get it to Pfizer to Huber. And CBC will win the puck. Shot back out to the SLU defense, though. Daw and Huber giving chase. Now there's Krogan. Krogan has it now all over the blue line.
And how big were the eyes of 22 Liam Nobby when Drew Krogan passed that one off the boards?
Watch it.
Frantic. Oh. Ooh, good shot there from Krogan.
Loose puck all around. CBC. Oh, shot back out by SLU. 2 minutes left here in the second period.
Oh.
Get back on net, Tommy. Come on.
Oh, and
there we go.
Pisaris to save the day. And here he is going forward this time. Good pass
from Bell. Bell tried to stick handle around. Pisaris is back there now. Wilhelm. Nothing. Into the net.
Yeah, good look from Trevor Wilhelm. I think that is, you know, you credit Warnicki with the save. We talked about Pisaris being a baseball player. Wilhelm himself, a very good golfer, plays for me on the golf team.
Oh.
You should see this kid hit a golf ball, folks. The technique is absolutely perfect. It really is a beautiful thing to watch. He hits it so pure, and it translates into hockey. You watch his passing, his control of the puck, his control of the stick at him. Everything's perfect. It's amazing. Really a talented athlete.
CBC wins. Shot from the point. Ooh, nothing.
And that was Jeremy Huber, correction. Again, I think he wants a goal on senior night.
So here is CBC. Here's SLU now trying to get out of their own zone. CBC playing tight defense offside. So CBC and SLU are deadlocked here in the second period with 1 minute 26 seconds to go. My name's Tom Hardwick. I'm along Mr. Tom Eichwald. And we are live here at Afton Ice Rink on the final day of the regular season. CBC SLU, it's a fitting way to end it. Mr. Eichwald, we got 1 minute 26 seconds left in the second. How do you think it's going to end?
Well, I think if you could get a goal right here, you go into the third period with momentum, and that means a lot. And there's a trip. That's a very blatant trip. And so the goaltender's going to make his way off. You're going to have the extra man come on. And why not? Give it a go, boys.
Come on. Six men.
We talked about momentum here.
Six men might get a power play.
Got a delayed penalty coming. Oh, and a good look from Sissel. But it is saved by Warnicki. And CBC is going to have a power play opportunity here. But we were starting to say the intensity was starting to wane just a little bit in that second start of the second period. I think the best thing that happened to this game probably in the second period was that goal from SLU. It really kind of revived the intensity of this one. The hitting's back, the shooting's back. CBC currently 22-10 in shots on goal. So we're starting to see the missed opportunities for SLU starting to be missed opportunities for CBC. And we've already seen it result in a tie, in
face
a tying
off,
goal.
Face off, won by Bell. Dishes it back to Krogan. Krogan now. Oh, centering pass didn't work for one of the Huber boys. And it's shot back down on the penalty kill by SLU. So Napier has it around his net.
Leaves it for Wilhelm. Watch his passing. He never misses a pass.
So here he comes. Trying to go maybe coast to coast. He can score. Wilhelm fires it down. Nothing happens. Krogan stops the puck. Krogan has it nice and slow. I think they might be content to hold it here and take the power play into the third period.
Well, but so you got 21 seconds. You might as well, again, try to get one.
Here's Bell. Bell has it around the net. He's chased by number 7, Ott. Bell still has it. Centering pass, nothing works.
It was a good idea from Sollenbach to center with 7 seconds left. Got to get it back in. The power play is still waiting for you, whether you score or not, or whether you sit back or not, and that's going to do it.
So, end of the second, 1-1, deadlocked. What used to be called the Battle of Clayton Road, or a battle of, you know, SLU and CBC. It's always a battle. I don't care who you are. 57.
Now the Battle of Afton.
Battle. Yeah, this one is a battle. This one is a battle. And so now it's CBC versus SLU 1-1. We go to a commercial break. We'll be right back. And we are back here for the start of the third period. CBC has a man advantage here. 57 seconds of it. CBC will come away with the faceoff now with Josh Bell, who's going to corral it, and he's going to take it on the rush for the power play. Here's Krogan taking it over blue line, shoveled along ahead. There's Bell again. Bell has it, and it's shoveled back. SLU has it, and they're going to try and get it out, and they do. Very effective penalty killing. All the way down to the corner with Wilhelm. Trevor Wilhelm has it. He's going to leave it for Bell. Bell's going to take it now up. He's going to dish it all the way onto the back to Salenbach, but he can't handle it. But it's kept in by Drew Krogan, who's been a rock at the back all night. Here comes Krogan again. Has Salenbach on the wing. Salenbach keeps it in. Oh, fired way out. That puck was sailing through the air.
Yeah, it's good defending from Andrew Ott.
So there's CBC with the puck. Napier smacking it on the ice, saying, let's go, let's go. Penalty's over. And so now we are back at even strength here. Dished off. CBC has the puck back around the net. Caceres is there. Sissel will corral it. He'll dish it off again. CBC keeps the puck. There's Ben Jones with it now. Here's Jones in deep. Centering pass, nothing comes. SLU has it now. They're going to go back on the rush. Taken away by CBC, and it's going to be offside.
I think you're seeing an interesting blend of styles here, too, because you have CBC who's looking to play the centering pass. They're looking to get that quality open shot, with the goalie on the wrong side of the net. They're looking to kind of get in behind the extended goal line and pass it back. Whereas SLU, you're seeing they're taking a lot of shots from up near the point and relying on their center play to try to maybe deflect it a little bit. So just a little bit different approach, which has been very, very interesting. And so far, it's resulted in exactly one goal apiece, despite CBC with a clear shot advantage.
So here's a good play there by Krogan to keep it. And fired back into the SLU. Drew Krogan, folks, right now is playing one of the games of his life. CBC has it giving chase. SLU. Now there's Paceris. Paceris is going to take a cross-ice pass there for Bell. Bell has it flying up the wing. Oh, I'm sorry, that's Daw. Over to Roof, who loses the puck to the SLU defense. Paceris there to keep it in. Huber couldn't do it. Goes all the way down, and Krogan's back there in the corner. Back now to Huber. Huber's going to take it, trying to go on the rush. Huber, nice and physical, tries to keep it but can't. And Krogan has it. I wonder if SLU's trying to sit back here. I wouldn't think so. Here's Krogan. Now he's going to dish it off to Huber. Huber takes it over the blue line and in the zone. Shot's blocked there. Huber still has the puck. Wrap around shot. Nothing.
That didn't need much. All that needed was a little flick.
Now there's Krogan with the shot, but nothing comes of that. CBC on the cycle now. Shot high into the net. And that's not coming out of the net. That lodged in the... Somebody's got a souvenir, maybe.
Yeah, I don't know if high school hockey has the budget to make those souvenirs. I think you got to toss them back.
Yeah, that's true.
It won't stop them from trying, though, but they might send somebody after you.
Yeah, it's like seeing the...
There's not much room to run here in Afton Ice Rink.
It's like seeing the ball get caught in the net at Wrigley Field. So here's CBC, who will... Ooh, can't win the faceoff. Foot race. Who's going to win that one? Will it be Huber? It'll be Huber and Wilhelm. Wilhelm gave chase. Great defense there by Trevor. Now it's Salenbach. Salenbeck's trying to shuffle it ahead. The referee's in the way. Salenbach keeps it. And it's dished off to the SLU defense, and Willis keeps it in. CBC putting on good pressure. The captain, Drew Krogan, keeping the rock in. Fired it off the boards. Ricocheted off into the net. So we have another face-off. Mr. Eichwald, we have 11:29 left in the third period. What do you think CBC has to do to be able to win this game?
Well, I think they have to pick up the intensity. I think most of the hitting you've seen, with the exception of that one from Jeremy Huber, has been from SLU. So I think you got to get up in people's faces. I think you have to up the speed. They've been beaten to a couple of those loose pucks. by the Junior Bills, and I think those are the things that you need to be doing. Again, you've got a 23-10 shot advantage. I mean, it's not like you're slacking out, you know, off of this game, but you could very easily put this game away with just a little step up in intensity, get another goal. You know, all of a sudden, maybe SLUH starts to feel up against the ropes, but it's not going to happen if the intensity doesn't go up here for SLUH, or for CBC, rather.
So there was a shot by number 10, Pat Pence, on Tommy Napier, and that'll be corralled in his glove against his chest, and CBC will come off with a line change. Yeah, it is 23-10, folks, on shots, and this is beginning to look like one of those St. Louis Blues games where you win like 40 shots to 20 and you hit the post 7 times and you can't score.
Well, I think a big part of that's been Warnke, but you've also seen shots at Warnke.
Here's Roof. Shot. Ooh, tried to go through the legs.
There's another example. Yes, it's a good save, but still, you're not gonna score on Joe Warnke with that shot.
CBC has it. Ooh, bouncing puck to the point, blocked. Pfizer out there. Shot saved by Warnke. That was a shot by.
That was Van Kramer.
Van Kramer. I'm sorry.
And that's a quality shot. You make Warnke work side to side for that one. We're gonna get new lines out here. Well, we do have 1 second. I want to let you know that you can join us for the 2015 CBC Father-Son Banquet Wednesday, January 28th at the Westport Chalet. St. Louis Cardinals President Bill DeWitt III is our special guest speaker. Sign up today at the Parents Club website. That's parentsclubcbc.com. Fathers, uncles, grandfathers, and friends are all welcome. Again, you can reserve your spot Wednesday, January 28th, parentsclubcbc.com. Be sure to check it out, and hopefully you can join us.
If you hadn't read an article recently on STL Today, Bill DeWitt was recently named one of the best St. Louis sports owners as they rank them from best to worst.
Well deserved.
Oh, yeah. Least can be said for Stan Kroenke. But so.
Well, we'll see how this plays out before we start.
Before we start.
He has gone to the big leagues owning Arsenal in England. You know, he's owned the Denver Nuggets.
Yeah.
Colorado Avalanche. A couple of lacrosse teams here and there.
Yep. And CBC goes offside again. So we're starting to get, like, people starting to get one way and get one way, and nothing's really coming of it. And we're getting a lot of face-offs right now, Mr. Aquam.
We are. And I think it disrupts the flow of the game, which at this point I think benefits SLUH a little bit more than it benefits CBC. I think the more the game
Salen just back. Ooh, no.
The more the game settles into a rhythm, I think the talent for CBC, gives you an advantage. But the more it's broken up on these face-offs, you start to get opportunities for SLUH that they wouldn't have otherwise.
Now here's Bell, who's going to dish it for Dembski. He's going to give it to Salenbeck, who's going to dish it back for Willis. Ooh! All the way through. And now it's Willis again. Willis skating through, shot save, bouncing all around, nothing.
Slowback!
Slowback! Spencer Slowback! Thank you! 2-1 CBC! 9:38 to go, it's 2-1! Thank you! Thank you, Spencer!
And that's a big one. We started to talk about the momentum going to SLUH. I think a goal like that kind of restores order. Everybody kind of settles down a little bit if you're CBC. And I would look for CBC to start amping up the pressure, not in kind of a sporadic way, but in a steady way. It's almost like a vice grip that's going to be tightened. I would expect that for CBC. I think we're going to see more possession in the SLUH zone. I think we're going to see a little bit cleaner defending. I think we're going to see some better shape from the CBC team.
So here's Roof now, who's going to dish it off. CBC still has it. It's down around in front of the SLUH. Uh-oh, centering pass. Saved by Warnke.
And it's good alertness from Warnke because that puck was just sitting there. Van Kramer was very, very nearly able to get a stick on that.
The freshman Van Kramer, number 8. He wears number 8. He has big shoes to fill, Joey Lupo. And so now Roof is back in with Wes and Sissel to take the faceoff. Krogan is back on defense with Becerra. Oh, he whiffed at it. And here comes SLUH on a 2-on-2 play. Back around the net.
And nice job by Krogan to get his body in front of that.
Good play there by Napier. Now Paceris. Paceris be wise to dump it off. He does. Now Van Kramer dishes it off again. Uh-oh, nothing can come of that one either. CBC trying to get it out of their own zone. They will. skating hard, dished off. SLU's going to win the puck battle, take it back into the offensive zone. CBC again with it, dishes it. And they're trying to disrupt SLU's flow right now. Now Krogan back. The Rock flicks it high and far and out. Billikens have to recycle. Krogan, what are your thoughts on Drew Krogan today, Mr. Eichwald?
Well, he's been good. He's brought his usual intensity. He had a couple of moments where I thought he was a little bit out of position in the first period. And I guess at the start of the second period, too. But he really has solidified. And, you know, to be fair, CBC did not get penalized for any of those. They weren't punished for any of those poor positionings. And I think things have settled down a little bit. And I thought he's been flawless in the last 12 minutes or so.
So Pfizer out there now with Daw and Huber. So there's West now. Looks like the lines have been shaken up a bit. Uh-oh, gotta watch out, Huber. Oh.
He did a good job to find that puck.
Keeps it in. It's like almost being an outfielder. And players are falling down all around the ice.
That's what happens when you try to hit Zach Pfizer. Kind of bounce off.
Shot! Ricocheted off on the deflection. Trying to fire it out of the zone. Can't do it. CBC's going to win the puck. Flicked out. And they will finally get it out. And we'll get a few fresh legs on here. Dished off. CBC's going to keep the puck now with Willis.
And importantly, Krogan back on.
Cycling out, but can't keep it on the flick. And SLU's going to have it 7 minutes and now 10 seconds. Puck's bouncing all around. Here's Bell. Bell's going to dish it for Huber. Huber shot, save. Oh, I'm sorry, that was Willis, saved by Warnke.
And good save by Warnke. Willis a little bit frustrated. That's a great opportunity. And I think good job by Warnke getting over there. But again, it's a shot right to his chest. So I think he'll take those all day long, folks.
28-12 on shots. 2-1 on goals in favor of the Cadets. And CBC trying to hang on.
I guess with shot totals like that, I should say he has taken those all day long.
Oh, yeah. Now SLU trying to get something going on a two-man rush. Broken up now by Willis. He's going to fire it out. CBC's going to keep the puck. Now SLU has it. And fired back down for Napier. Napier's going to keep it, and he's going to tease Drew Krogan with it, but he's going to throw it back the other way. Uh-oh, watch out. Watch out. Oh,
now, it did not go in. The goal was off its moorings.
Ho-ho! A break.
The goal was off its moorings. Now, I think that's probably the right call.
Woo!
Because it went in the near post, and the goal was moving as it went in, so you can't quite tell exactly what happened first.
So CBC catches a break. CBC catches a break, folks. Good eye by the ref. And Kevin Fitzpatrick is livid over there on the SLU bench. He is arguing with the referee, trying to figure out what happened. John Jost, Randy Staub, and Nick Carosello just content to sit there behind the bench.
And good call, officials.
Thank you.
The SLU fans letting our officiating crew know what they think. There was no hesitation, though, from the referee. He was in a great position. Waved it off right away. Didn't even have to think about it. So you tend to give him the benefit of the doubt, of course. It's a difficult job.
But now we do have a penalty. We do have a penalty for Ben Jones at the two-minute minor. And there's 6:34 left in this game. 28-14 in favor of the Cadets. 2-1 in favor of the Cadets. Third period.
Yeah, it looks like they got him on a cross-check down there. Hard for us to see from up here. We were kind of looking at the official and looking at the goal. I guess one of the linesmen was looking at what was going on in the middle and saw it.
Oh, yep. So now, just so we can tell everybody, the CBC versus SLU games do tend to come down to this tight of a wire. The first game I ever called came down to a very final breakaway with a save by Joe Staley, and I lost my voice during the call. So here's a shot from the point by SLU.
Well, and that's what you want. And I mentioned earlier that a lot of times CBC does this, SLU does this. You play a lot of teams, that you know you blow out or you win, 8-0, you win, 12-1. You hear those kinds of scores, and it's so nice to be able to play, especially this late in the season, quality opposition where you're in close games. Because you know, once you get in the playoffs and you're seeing DeSmet, Chaminade, SLUH regularly, Oakville, Lindbergh, you're seeing that quality of teams. You need to know that you're able to hang in a close game. So goals, games like this, whether you win them or lose them, are invaluable come the postseason.
So CBC on the penalty kill, trying to just get it out of their zone, kill this penalty, get 2 minutes closer to victory here. Cadets think that the SLUH went offside.
That was a close one.
They're caught at the point, bouncing all around. Nothing happening. And another penalty is going to get called. And it'll be 5-on-3.
And they're going to get somebody on a trip. I think they're getting Krogan on the trip.
Oof. That's a big loss.
No, he doesn't like that call at all.
No. 5-on-3 for almost the remainder of the game. At least 3 minutes, 24 seconds of this 5:58. And it is 1 minute, 24 seconds left for Ben Jones and 2 minutes left for Krogan. You got two of your best players in the box tonight.
And you do, but at the same time, CBC, a very, very deep team. I mean, defensively, you got people like Trevor Wilhelm, who is, he's only a junior, but so calm, so assured of himself, so confident. So I really think that he is a player who can come up in a situation like this. You have Josh Bell. You have Clayton Dawes, Zach Pfizer. You got all kinds of people you can call on, really. And even Van Kramer, who I think has been good tonight. So you have a lot of options. And then defensively, yes, Krogan's off, but you've got Dembski. You've got Jeremy Huber on senior night. You have Trevor Wilhelm. I think CBC is going to be all right here. I think regardless of who you have out there, I think the fact that these two penalties are so close together, so for a minute and 24 seconds, you're going to be playing two men down. And I think that's the biggest concern of all here.
And CBC is really, really got to show what they've got here. If they can kill this 1 minute 24 without getting the tying goal and kill off these 2 minutes, that will be one of the biggest stands of the year for the Cadets. And this late season battle, if they can win a faceoff here, this is big. And they will win the faceoff. Trevor Wilhelm corrals it for CBC. SLUH comes away.
And correction, Willis is out there. He is the one who scored, mind you, on the exact same situation, 3-on-5 against DeSmet. Good save from Napier. You're probably going to need a few of those. But, again, Jones the penalty, so you have you do have Willis out there. I might have misspoke earlier, but.
Let's see who's out there. You got Bell, you got Willis.
And you have Wilhelm.
And you have Trevor Wilhelm. So you got three key players out there.
Well, and
CBC.
You have Wilhelm, who's your rock right now. And then you have Willis. Ooh, that's a dangerous one. You have Willis and Bell, who are both very, very quick on their feet, which is so important when you're shifting defensively, when you got to keep rotating that triangle, which is all that three-man defense is.
Saved by Napier.
Good read from Napier. He put himself in a perfect position there.
All the way down. CBC has it.
And three fresh pairs of legs right now. Jeremy Huber in back. You got Clayton Daw, and then you have Zach Pfizer in there.
So now CBC catching a break there, trying to get it away from SLUH. They will fire it out. SLUH has to recycle. 22 seconds left in the Jones minor. And now CBC trying to get it to the 5-on-4, a lot more easy than 5-on-3. Daw now to get it for the Cadets, trying to force it out. It's trapped in there. Good defense, fired out by Daw. All the way down to Warnicke, and it's 5-on-4 now. 35 seconds left. Can the Cadets kill this off? 4 minutes, 28 seconds.
And that is Jones right back out there rather than somebody else. He's going to go out for the next 24 seconds and try to see this one through.
So here's CBC again, knocked out. Yes! Great defense there by Jack West to poke it out. I'm sorry, that was Pfizer. And so now CBC are 9, 8, 7 seconds away from killing this penalty off. A great stand by the Cadets. And they're back at even strength. They killed it off. Great job by CBC. Willis giving chase.
You know, I think that's huge. But when you look at the fact that SLUH only got off about two shots there. I mean, there was a couple blocked by defenders. Napier made, two?
We got for Salenbeck. Shot.
Three saves tops in a minute and 24 seconds, a 5-on-3. I think SLUH would be a little bit frustrated with that.
Krogan now. Krogan can't handle it. He's going to throw it back to the net. Behind the net for Salenbeck, who's backed up by Willis. Willis has it. It's going to go all the way out. 2-on-2. Willis gives chase to break it up. He can do that. It goes all the way back around the net, and CBC will have it now. Now Salenbeck has it. Fly-eyeing up the wing. And nice little move there by Andy Willis, but can't keep the puck. CBC trying to get it going. 3 minutes left here, folks. 2-1. There is no overtime in regular season high school hockey in Mid-States. CBC has the puck now. I think they're just going to try and keep the puck as much as they can, maybe try and score a goal. If they can score a goal, I would say this game could be effectively over.
You got to be careful saying that in the MCC, Tommy. I mean, we're knocking on there actually is a wood surface up here knock upon, which is nice. But, again, anything can happen. 2 minutes and 30 seconds is a lot of time, with teams of this caliber especially.
Warning can't hold it around the net. 2:20 now. SLUH trying to keep it. They can't. It'll come back to Krogan, who will dish it off. Krogan now again. He's going to fire it up. Nice little passing play, Krogan. Offside.
Yeah, it wasn't by much, but it's a good call. The pass from Dahl was just a little bit behind him.
Clayton Dahl been a really good player tonight for CBC. And it's Sissel, Wes, and Roof out there. And looks like Sissel took the faceoff. Can't win it, though. It'll go into the CBC zone. And Krogan giving chase for the Cadets. Now Roof tries to get it around. Thrown back out. And SLUH has to come all the way out of the zone. And it's into the ceiling off of the stick of number 24, Jeremy Huber. And in for a faceoff. 1 minute, 53 seconds left. And the Cadets could improve to a 29-2 record.
And that puck hit right in front of Sam Hageman, who for some reason, one of the managers, was standing right there down by himself all at the end of the ice. Wonder if he got booted from the bench for something he probably thought was hilarious, or if he was running an errand or what. But
Sam, who knows with him sometimes. Uh-oh, here's Krogan. Oh,
he's
out.
Tripped. That's a blatant trip.
Where is that?
There is no excuse for not seeing that one. The stick was left. Got him, pulled his leg out from under him. I think that's a clear one that the referees got wrong. Good save from Napier. He takes the puck and Jeremy Huber with him. And so, that's an impressive one.
And so CBC is able to stop the rush of SLUH. 1 minute, 26 seconds left. It's 29-18 on shots. And so out there will be Ben Jones that I can see. That's the only number I can right now.
Well, and Brendan Huber's out there, and Zach Pfizer is, Trevor Wilhelm back there, and Clayton Dahl, it looks like.
Bouncing all around and saved by Napier once again. Tommy Napier has really been good, stopping 17 of 18 shots of the Junior Bills. He did get lucky with one mooring coming loose.
Yeah, and I can't tell if he had the near post covered on that. But it certainly looked like the goal maybe coming off the mooring certainly helped that puck go in. It's a close one regardless, but I think good call from the officials. I mean, a goal in a game like this is huge, so you got to make sure that there is no doubt if you're going to give it.
And we are about to be inside a minute now. CBC has the puck. They're going to be smart with it and pass. Dishes it now for Jones. Jones is going to fire it in, dump and chase. Warnke, 52 seconds left. Got to get back. SLUH is really putting the pressure on. There's Pfizer giving chase. SLUH keeps the puck. Nope, fired in by CBC. And the Cadets really putting the pressure on. There's Huber. Huber been playing a good game for him tonight.
And Huber gets away
with it. Here's Bell. Oh, he was centering pass for Willis. Couldn't do it.
Probably could have taken the shot there, but
25.
Huber got away with a little trip there, too. So I guess both teams getting a little bit of leeway on the trips.
Inside 20 seconds. Taken away by CBC.
That's Wilhelm.
Trevor Wilhelm dishes it. 10 seconds left. Students jumping around. Here comes a countdown.
And the goaltender's pulled for SLU.
Goalie's pulled. Fire it down, boys. Get it down there.
2 seconds.
2-1. CBC wins it here on senior night. 2-1 with a goal by Spencer Sallenbach midway through the third. And they will gather at the other end of the ice and embrace Tommy Napier, who was a rack of the back. And a great game played by Joe Warnicki and the Junior Bills as well. We are going to go to a quick commercial break, and we will be back with your post-game analysis. This is Tom Hartpick and Tom Eichwald on the Cadet Student Network. Oh. And we are back here on the Cadet Student Network after that break. And CBC comes away with the win 2-1 over the Junior Bills tonight. They improved to a record of 29-2, and SLU falls to 19-5-2. Now we're back with your three stars here, and we've got a tough draw to call for CBC. My first star, in my opinion, has to be Tommy Napier stopping 19-20 shots from the Junior Bills. The second star, what would you think, Mr. Eichwald?
Well, I think the second star should probably go to Joe Warnicki. I think he made a lot of big saves to keep SLU in this game. I mean, you look at that shot differential, and the fact that SLU was still in this game late, I mean, yes, a lot of those shots were right at him, but he also put himself in those positions, and he made one or two phenomenal saves when they weren't right at him. So I think you really have to give Joe Warnicki some credit for keeping him in this game.
Now, for the first star, we really have to choose, you know, someone who is, you know, exemplary throughout the game. You got the two goal scorers of Sallenbach and Ben Jones, and Sallenbach with a great, great heroic goal. But, I mean, Drew Krogan, really the senior on senior night, really kept the Cadets in there all night on defense.
And I was thinking the same thing. I mean, the goals were good, but when you look at Drew Krogan's impact, not only in the defensive side of the game, but also on the offensive side, in every part of the game, Drew Krogan was involved. And again, just being the leader in the intensity for CBC tonight on senior night, you got to give it to Drew Krogan.
Yep, so we got Napier, Warnicki, and Krogan for your three stars here tonight. This is the last game of the regular season. And thank you to all the students who helped us tonight. Josh Williams, Charlie Hines, Max running the board. Myself, my name's Tom Hartbeck. I was alongside Mr. Tom Eichwald. Thank you also to Mr. Patrick Walsh and everyone who helped us over at Lindenwood tonight. Thank you very much, too. It's been a great night for CSN. My name's Tom Hartbeck, and I'm signing off. I will see you guys next time.